How do you like that?
Hey everyone, this is Shannon Lee. Welcome to El Rey Network's presentation of Game of Death, produced, written, directed, choreographed, and starred in by my father. Game of Death was originally started in 1972. However, it was put on hold because my father went to go do Enter the Dragon. And originally the idea is he would come back and finish Game of Death, but unfortunately, he passed away before he was able to do that. My father had shot some really amazing footage. So the film was finished by Golden Harvest and some of my father's friends, Raymond Chow and Robert Klaus, and a number of my other friends like Bob Wall and Sammo Hung all came together to finish this film.
We're all in this together.
The story was changed and there were body doubles used and some other sort of lo-fi analog 70s tricks.
Okay, that's a print.
And finally released in 1978. The original plot, my dad played a character named Hai Tian, who was a retired martial artist who was brought out of retirement to go and receive some kind of mysterious item that is hidden at the top of a pagoda. Each level of the pagoda is defended by a different martial artist of a different style. My father brought in Dan Inosanto to play the Eskrima Master, and so we got to hang out with Dan, who was a good family friend. And he also brought in Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, or as he was known back then, Lou, to play the Master at the Top, as well as famous Hapkido fighter, Jihan Jae. The fight scene with Dan is, most notably, it is the first time on film that you will ever see a nunchuck versus nunchuck fight scene. In Game of Death, my father was really getting to explore some of his thoughts and philosophies around martial arts. And in this movie, he chose Hapkido master Jihan Jae to really show off some of his grappling skills. And this was way ahead of his time, really not been seen before, with him, a kung fu man, going up against a grappler. In the film, Kareem plays the master of the style of no style, which was really part of the philosophy of Jeet Kune Do. So my father has to come up and really learn how to adapt in this fight, again, exemplifying his philosophy around martial arts. The tracksuit. This film is the one with the infamous and now iconic yellow and black tracksuit. My father actually chose this tracksuit because for him, it represented the style of no style. He really believed in the formless form, and the tracksuit represents that as well as himself as an individual. Now it's time for you to put on your yellow tracksuit and lace up those tigers and get ready for El Rey Network's presentation of Game of Death.